Here on the Suncoast, thousands more marched along the Ringling Bridge to join that effort. This comes just 1 month after President Donald Trump released his tax returns from 2005. ABC 7's Erica Jackson joins us live from the Bayfront with more on why this is a big deal for many locals. Erica?
Adam, Donald Trump is the first president in more than 40 years to not release multiple tax returns, and local protesters think that there's a reason that he's holding back private information.
I think he's definitely got something to hide. If he had nothing to hide, he wouldn't be trying to hide them.
In front of the unconditional surrender statue, more than 2,000 voters are pressuring President Donald Trump to surrender his tax returns.
We believe it could possibly explain a lot of his business ties and possibly show us some things we need to know.
The organization Action Together Suncoast bringing together Democrats, Republicans, and independents just ahead of tax day. President Trump released his tax returns from 2005, but demonstrators want him to follow his predecessors and release multiple returns publicly.
Some people are digging. You know, they found the 2005, they saw the 2005 tax returns and they said, we didn't find anything, now we need to see more.
There are several bills in the legislature requiring presidential candidates to release their three most recent tax returns. But for now, local Republican leaders say that's unnecessary.
There is no law requiring the president to release his tax returns. Just like a few years ago, there was no law requiring President Obama to release his birth certificate. Just like there's no law requiring Hillary to release her personal emails.
Yes, truth matters. Yes, truth matters.
Instead of following the same path as January's Women's March, Action Together Suncoast partnered with Sarasota Police to create a new route. Demonstrators crossed underneath the Ringling Bridge in order to allow traffic to flow smoothly and keep marchers safe. Kathy Thies believes their message could have reached more people.
Going under the bridge gave us a lot less time to show our protest to because there's nobody down there. So it would have been much better to go just completely over it.
Action Together Suncoast says voters can continue to make their voices heard by going to local legislators, giving them a call, and letting them know that they want them to support those bills going through the legislature that would require vice presidential and presidential candidates to release multiple tax returns. Reporting live from the Ringling Bridge, I'm Erica Jackson. Adam, back to you in the studio.